Now entering Pokemon Tower. This is supposed to be a graveyard for Pokemon, and I got to wonder, can a Pokemon die if it's hit hard enough in battle? I mean, we all know it faints when it falls in battle, but can it be hit hard enough that it would die? Like, a level 1 Geodude would be hit by a surfing level 100 Kyogre, and would it still just faint? Or it's not even described how hard it faints. It would be the same whether it's a hit that's just enough to make it faint, or a really vicious hit that could kill it 1,000,000 times over. Regardless, Blue's waiting for me up there, and after 4 losses in a row to me, he ought to be pissed. And as I said last time, his team is vastly improved over the last time I fought him. That Raticate is gone. Instead, it made way for a Gyarados and an Execute. Not bad choices, but I don't think they know moves threatening enough to take me down just yet, but that's going to change before the end of the game. So, fighting that damn Pidgeotto again for the 4th time. Hopefully no sand attack. Oh, quick attack, a cheap lick. So, yeah, good choice considering I can one-hit KO him. And what's next now? Execute. So, what I do? I'm gonna keep this out because Alakazam would struggle a bit. Psybeam would be not very effective. A Body Slam still isn't enough. Oh no! Not Hypnosis! Now I'm going to catch a Snooze Cruise. I don't know how long it'll be, but oh, Barrage, yeah. It's a barrage of what, in fact? Eggs? Does it throw its own heads towards me? By the way, speaking of which, that head in the middle is really, really big. I think it's even it's much larger than in other games, by the way. Okay, so I woke up, so I'm just gonna finish that thing. Good. Here comes Gyarados. Now I'm gonna keep Venusaur out just out of curiosity. Way back at the beginning, I've talked about a few theories that... Oh man, I missed with Razor Leaf. Talk about bad luck here. But anyway, I wanted to see just how my theories held up regarding type effectiveness when one type cancels the other out. So it was written not very effective, not a surprise since, well, there's one theory that says not very effective has priority. Another one says type 2 has priority. This holds up too. But I'm almost surprised I got to kill it in one hit. So that theory, according to which the message display and the sound that plays is just a glitch, well, it's holding up pretty well right now. So just like last time, I kept Venusaur out against his Kadabra because I wanted to hit the lower defense, something Alakazam couldn't do, and it would be not very effective on top of that. And here we go. One Psybeam later, Charmeleon is dead, and, well, 5th victory over Blue for me. Yeah, 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 you took it easy. How about admitting that your team sucks for once? Hey, stop calling me pal. I hate you, you hate me. We're not pals. And since he's talking about Cubone, there are Cubones available to catch, but like the Ghastlies and Haunters, they're ghosts. Now, how does that make sense? I mean, sure, Ghastly and Haunters are ghosts, but Cubone is just ground, and I don't think those are dead either. The Marowak at the end is dead. I think we all know that it's the Marowak that's been referred to in town. The Marowak that had been killed by Team Rocket. Is there something down there? Nope. It looks conspicuous, but nope. Doesn't seem to be anything there. But back to those Cubones. How can they be ghosts? It doesn't make sense. And on top of that, Blue just said he caught one, so does he already have a Sylphscope? How did he get his? Speaking of which, some extra shilling of the Sylphscope, though I won't be getting mine for a while, and here we go. Now we're entering hostile territory with wild ghosts that you can't catch. Because that's something else. If you try to fling a ball at those ghosts, they're gonna dodge it. You can only catch them if you unveil their true identity with the Sylphscope. So, wait a minute. The Sylphscope also has the power to prevent ghosts from dodging balls? How does that work? Oh, and the exception is the Marowak at the top. Even with the Silph Scope, it's gonna dodge. Wait, I forgot to change my lead to Alakazam? Well, that sucks. That was stupid. Why did I do that? It's not like Venusaur can do much. Body Slam can never hit. And I can't imagine Razor Leaf doing too much either. And Nightshade, coming from an enemy at this point of the game, is probably the most dangerous attack there is. There's not much in any Pokemon's arsenal that can deal 22 damage. If I have such a level advantage. And just to nitpick, was that Ghastly possessing the Channeler, or was it a Ghastly the Channeler caught? Because looking at the animation, it sure looked like it belonged to the Channeler, but if you talk to her, she'll tell you she was possessed by it. So, yeah, that's really not too well explained. No matter how you look at it, the explanation's flopped. Oh, and look at that. Ghastly doesn't really look like it should in Red and Blue. I don't know how you can manage to mess up a gas bubble, but they did. And it's not too creative either. I mean, a gas bubble that leaves a small trail of smoke? Yeah, anyone could come up with that. And Haunter is much better. In fact, I think it's worse. It's like a lollipop ghost, except it's purple and its hands aren't attached to its body. But overall, it really looks like just a plain average ghost. And the name Haunter, probably the worst ever in Pokemon history. Now Gengar is cool, really, really cool, but Ghastly and Haunter aren't. And you know the catch? They're first generation Pokés. That means whenever someone complains that they've run out of ideas, you can just look at Ghastly and Haunter and other really lame names like Slowpoke, and you could almost safely say, using their logic, that they never had any ideas to begin with. If anything, they're getting a little more creative each time. Personally, I remember the time Piplup's English name was unveiled. There was an absolute riot. Worst name ever. You see the kind of thing? There were even people saying, I won't play Pokemon ever again. They've officially run out of ideas. Never mind that, you know, people are still playing it and they've gotten used to the name no matter how bad it is. Personally, I liked it. I think it was one of the better names for starters, actually, because starters never really had names that were that good. Piplup's was really upper tier, in my opinion, when it comes to starter names. But anyway, people really don't mind that much anymore, because really, the fourth generation Pokés have blended in with the rest, and now people don't do anything in terms of distinction between each generation, at least people that really like the franchise. And really, which generation is a Poké from is more trivia than anything else now. But the whining back then, that was really stupid. I mean, comparing to another game that's due in a few years, Diablo 3, the complaints people have mostly have to do with the actual gameplay. Whichever side of the issues you stand on, you can make pretty good arguments for each side. I mean, aside from the Necromancer is much cooler than the Witch Doctor, wah, 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 but that has nothing to do with the gameplay, and those people shouldn't be taken seriously. But really, there's no one who complains that Improved Charged Bolt is a stupid name for a skill, so what gives? No one gives a shit, and rightfully so! Okay, so I'm gonna finish off that trainer, and then that's gonna be it for this part. And since Pokemon Ranger 2 comes out tomorrow, and it's gonna be keeping me busy for a while, I don't know when the next couple of videos will take place, so I suppose you'll just have to wait and see. But if you're getting Ranger 2 as well, I hope you enjoy it, and I suppose I'll see you in the next part. Hey, they misspelled Elixir, idiots!